Happy Thumbs Gaming. We shall.
Hey everybody, it's Brian with Happy Thumbs Gaming. Today we have another LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens video for you. This one happens to be for Level 6 Battle of Takodana Story. That's right, we're going to ring off a trophy achievement called Don't Let These Dogs Scare You. We're also going to shoot for that true Jedi requirement, but I have to be honest, we fall short of the halfway mark of that, so we don't quite get a gold brick for that, but we do get a gold brick for completing the level, and we also get a couple of character and vehicle tokens unlocked for beating this area as well. So here we are, we find ourselves on the hub planet Takodana, and Takodana. And we're going to go ahead and destroy a whole bunch of plants to grab some studs. But more importantly, we're going to make our way around to this rock wall. We're going to climb up to the top. And for some reason, Poe to the Rescue is now available. So that was kind of weird. Usually they give us those for completing a level or something, which maybe it was just coming late. I don't know. But we're going to follow the blue stud trail all the way over to the staff switch. We're going to go ahead and insert Ray's staff, and we're going to go ahead and spin to win. Oh, look at that, BB-8 takes a ride up to the top, and as you might have noticed, over on the right-hand side over there, there was an electrical panel that, or an astromech, well, it was one of the panels, it's a BB-8 panel, how about that? There it is, and we're going to go ahead, it's a rotary one, we're going to go ahead and hop in it, and then press to the upper side, the north. And watch that door raise, and look at that, we've got a little hologram path in the back indicating that's where we go for the next story, and we're going to go ahead and jump into that right now. Actually, we're going to try to milk a few more studs. Got to have them all. All right, we'll go ahead and watch the credits roll, or the text roll anyways, and we'll see you after the cutscenes.
It was the Republic! The First Order, they've done it. Where's Rey?
We must face them. Fight them. All of us. I've had this for ages. Kept it locked away.
Where'd you get that?
A good question for another time. Take it. Find your friend. Those beasts.
Uh-oh, look out, we got ourselves a lightsaber. All right, so there's a handful of studs in this hallway, but there's a couple of bad guys around the corner. You can actually build up a little bit of a multiplier before collecting those studs. So we're gonna do that. We got a 2x, and then a 3, a 4. We got a 4, that's about all we could get. But times 4 is good enough for me. I know that in Marvel, you could get a 10x, maybe even Jurassic 2. I can't remember if Jurassic had them or not, actually. But anyway, I know we've seen at least 10x rapid succession multipliers for taking out bad guys in previous games. It seems like 4 might be the highest you can get in this one, but that's all right. We'll take it. And once we get all the way to the end of this hallway and collect all the studs, we can actually use our lightsaber for the first time. So simply walk up to the circle and press the button indicated. And we're going to go ahead and press down to rip through that door. And look at that, it opens up and there's chaos ensuing outside. But yeah, we're going to go ahead and take it like a real Jedi would and run out there and try to see if we can do some damage. And it turns out that statue thing on the right is impenetrable even to my lightsaber that I'm wielding. And we find a few bad guys out here. We're going to take those guys out and then make our way over to this door. You can see there's that, like, jail cell thing on the right-hand side. We're going to go ahead and use our lightsaber to slice and dice right through that bad boy. Watch out for the fire, too. He's a spicy stormtrooper. I don't know. Sorry. That might have been terrible. Anyhow, we're going to go ahead and slice and dice this metal grate over here. And then we're going to switch on over to Maz Kanata. And she is actually small enough, she can get through the hatches. So, woo to the hoo! Now we're upstairs, and we're going to smash and build. Look at this, we've got a multi-build here. And, well, maybe we do. Wait for it, wait for it. Actually, it's not a multi-build, it's just a single build. My bad. And we're going to go ahead and build up the checkerboard pathway here, which is going to allow us to push this box or crate off the ledge and smash it down below. Now, there's clearly some free play stuff up there, some sort of a scan or something needed up there. And we are, I don't think Maz can scan. My notes don't say anything about being able to get it or try to miss it. So, anyhow, the multi bricks are down below. That's where the multi, and check this out. We built a birthday cake. And the old flaming stormtrooper lights up the cake and says, oh no, it's not a huge cake. Boom. That's right. Take out a couple of those bad guys the old-fashioned way. It's got to be one of the oldest tricks in the book. And all right. Ooh, look at that. The combat meter filled up. And Maz has a pretty awesome feature there. Now, all right. So the other build of the multi-build is actually some sort of a, ooh, it's a thermal imploder. And it blows up and takes out the giant statue, which falls right on top of that stormtrooper with the flamethrower. So he is now not an issue, and our crew advances up, and we find a heavy stormtrooper with a machine gun. And that's some serious pew-pewing going on there. But we find ourselves in another blaster battle. And if you notice up top, there is no notations for taking out the regular stormtroopers. It's simply noting the heavy. So focus on the heavy, but watch out. There's a sniper up above, and it kind of tells you when he's going to snipe, as you can see by the yellow arrows honing in. And, you know, if you're going for that gold for this particular blaster battle, you're going to definitely want to duck and dodge both the sniper rifle shots as well as the heavy shots too. So, watch out for the TIE fighter. He's going to strafe in and drop a proton torpedo, which doesn't do us much good. Oh, it almost takes us out. So we have to run from that, but it advances us up a little bit further. And now we can see we have a handful of stormtroopers we need to take out. I think the number was 5. And so we're going to go ahead and take those guys out. Oh, we're going to get blasted in the process too. Whoopsie. And all right, we're blasting heads off left and right, and we got one left, and no, oh, come on, quit rolling around. Just let me shoot you already. All right, check this out. Now all of a sudden, this random, what is that, a pirate? That random dude up there builds up a grapple handle, so you got to switch to somebody with the grappling ability, and in our case, it was Finn. And we have pulled ourselves up top, and now we can shoot down on this force-fielded heavy, and don't take out the actual stormtrooper shooting, take out the gun itself, and then we can drop back down, or you can shoot from above to take out the remaining stormtroopers, and there's like some special blaster trooper up there too. I think it's the sniper is what that one is notated as, but we're just thinning out their numbers. But we find that this is a pretty good spot to shoot from, because I don't think they even pay attention to you up here. And we do have the right angle to take out the sniper over there. And look at that. One shot, pow, right in the kissa. And he drops. And one guy left. And look at that. He's running around down on the ground. So we switch back to Maz, who finishes them off. Oh, look at that. He even pulled out a flower for his burial session. All right. We have another wave of blaster battling going on. This is by far the longest blaster battle we have experienced so far. And look at that, we've got a scanning point on the right-hand side over on the statue, so we need the quadnoculars of Mr. Han Solo. So we're going to switch to him by pulling up our character wheel by pressing and holding the triangle or Y button. And once he's out, we can aim those quad knocks right on the lower area of the statue. I was a little confused because I hit targeted the top part and it didn't even begin to hone in. But there it is. We have to target the bottom of it and check it out. Now that it's targeted, we can go ahead and get our blast on. And we have to use Chewie, so we call on old Chewie. And he tosses one of those, what is it, thermal grenades? I don't remember what they're called. But they blow up the statue, and it falls down on a bunch of the bad guys, and we advance to another part of the blaster battle. But the good news is we are almost done with this. We just have to take out the remaining troops. And look at that. We've got actually, we don't have to take out the remaining troops. We have to take out two heavies. So, yeah, I don't know if the thermal imploders work that good or the little mini grenades that Chewie has. I guess the thermal detonators, thermal imploders, something like that. They're a grenade, and you could toss those at him. I try to throw a couple out there right now. As you can see, it appears to take out the other guys, but it didn't seem to hurt him. He walked right through that one, didn't he? Yeah, and there's no hearts missing, so. Oh, but that one, look at that. Booyakashow. One shot, one kill. That, we'll take it. So maybe you should toss some of those to help you get through it if you're having troubles. Look at me. I'm just like, who wants a thermal detonator? Here, take one. And look, there's this turret here, too, that we could have mounted. But I believe it is within the reach of the fire. So you might find yourself getting hot, hot, hot. But all right, so we can move up the hill, and we find ourselves in another battle. This one is not a blaster battle, though. It's just a regular combat. And we have to take out a handful of bad guys. And then there's some sort of like riot trooper or something that pops out here in a second. I believe that's what we call those guys. He's got one of those, it's like a baton, electric baton. Yeah, here he is, the riot trooper. Yeah, and he calls us a traitor. And all right, so this is kind of like a battle of the fiercest. Really, he runs at us. I don't think there's any escaping his initial attack. Once he attacks a couple of times, he all of a sudden kind of pauses and becomes vulnerable. So at that point, you can go ahead and shoot or attack him. And I guess shooting is attacking him, but you know what I mean. The old melee combat. And once you remove a heart from him, it actually, he jumps back into his kind of safety zone there and activates his baton, which, look at this. Now he sends out some more bad guys, and we've got some multi-build bricks. So we're going to use the rule of three here. So he's going to attack you, which I don't think you can avoid. Then you have to take a heart off, which he will then return back to his home base, send some bad guys out. Once you defeat the bad guys, you have to build up the multi-build to remove a second heart, and then you have to repeat the process again. So we're in round two right now. He's already attacked me for the second time. I'm taking off a heart by getting up close and personal there. And now he returns to his home base, sending out some of his friends again, which we will take out and then build up the multi-build, which actually has three different possibilities. You're going to want to use each of the three. And I actually built the multi-build before taking out his buddies, but it still worked just the same. And now he's chasing us, and I don't think there's any escaping this. I really don't. If there is a way to dodge the attack, please let us know by dropping a comment, because I'm sure others reading this might find it useful in the future. But look, I mean, I'm just running, and he is, well, look at that. I guess I did dodge his attack there. Maybe I can dodge his attack. So maybe my dodging skills are just not up to par. But all right, he is jumping back up, calling out his buddies. He has destroyed our master build again, or our multi-build master build. Which game am I playing? All right, we build it up into this weird speaker like, oh, it's a magnet. It's not a speaker. Fooled me. And, okay, he is fed up with his singular baton. And wait, what? Wait, what's this? Oh, he's got skills, but so do we. So we're going to go ahead and, oh, spam that button. Spam it.
You don't.
You okay, big deal?
Important. They'll help you. What?
all I've heard so much about. The droid. Where is it?
Don't move. TK-338, we have targets in custody.
We have incoming at 28.6.
The resistance.
Go straight at him. Don't let these thugs scare you.
That's one hell of a pilot.
Rey and BB-8, they need you now. Go.
All right, let the games begin! We get to fly as Poe in the X-Wing. So this is pretty awesome. There is an actual Lego set that exists that you can build up into this very X-Wing. And I remember there was some sort of an issue with some of the hatches. Like it didn't close right or wouldn't open or something. But anyhow, we are excited to fly the X-Wing. And our task right now is to take out 15 TIE fighters. Now, there are plenty of TIEs flying around. But you got to pay attention to the boundaries. There's like this map down in the corner that's kind of a compass there. You have to stay within those dotted lines there. The dashed lines down there. That's kind of like our boundary zone, so let's make sure we stay inside of those. Now, there are a couple of mini kits and even a red brick in this area that are available in the story playthrough, but as you know, we always skip those so we can get them all in our free play video so you guys know right where all the collectibles are, and we can put the quick links down below and make it easy peasy for you. So if you are interested in getting those in your story mode playthrough, there are, I believe, 4 buoys floating around that you need to take out in the water. That gives you one of them. Now, there's another one for taking out some targets along the shore. They're like these kind of turret gun, like satellite thingies. I believe there's 3 of those. And there's also a red brick. So there's one of those buoys right there, right below me. And I believe that's one of the satellites right in front of me over there to the right side. So, and there was a building that came down. You can see the red brick right off to my right-hand side there. I believe that's where the destroy on contact red brick. I'm not 100% sure on that as I have not collected it yet. And I'd have to go look at our trophy achievement guide that Doug's put together. As a matter of fact, Doug is already on free play and actively, he's probably about halfway through it right now. So he's making good ground on that as I'm making good ground on the story. And speaking of story, we just have to take out the remaining trooper ships here. We've got a few more left. Looks like 5 total. Once we get those all downed, we will find ourselves in the kind of final little aerial battle here before it takes us to the final cutscene and to the totals. So yeah, these TIE escort ships or whatever the trooper ship, whatever these are, these guys are a little bit more resilient. They don't really like to go down on the first bullet or two. It takes 3 or 4. So I definitely recommend going slow as possible. I don't think there's an air brake, but there's certainly a boost that you can avoid pressing. And all right, looks like we got 2 left, and oh, there's a close one right there. We'll swoop all the way around for this final one, and then it should take us into a short little cinematic camera pan where it shows the, I believe there's some TIEs chasing our escape ships or something like that. But all right, here we go. Yep, there we go. We got a couple chasing our escape pod. I don't know if that's our escape. I don't know. I think, isn't Leia on that ship? I for some reason, I remember Leia being on that. Anyways, we're going to go ahead and take out, it looks like there's 3, 4, 5. There's a whole bunch of them, actually. Take out all of the ones marked in red and protect that green. And look at that. We've got 3 escape ships or 3 clusters of TIE fighters that we need to take out. We've got 1 check mark now, and we're about to work on the second one. Pew, 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 pew. Come on, man. Nope, wrong guy. Why are you following that guy? Keep in mind, you do get studs for any TIE fighter you take down that is not... Oh, look at that. Don't get cocky, kid. And I forgot to notate that in the beginning. I totally forgot I even got that trophy. That's awesome. What is that trophy achievement for? That one's for defeating 100 TIE fighters, I think. Whoa! I took a little dip right there. I dipped my toes in the water. All right, the final one. We get the final check mark, and it's going to take us to the final cutscene, which we'll see after that at the final totals. Now, let's be honest. I may not be the best pilot in the galaxy, but I'm up there.
fighters.
Pull the division out. Forget the droid. We have what we need.
He took her. She's gone.
Yeah, I know.
Goodness! Han Solo! It is I, C-3PO. You probably don't recognize me because of the red arm. Yes, I must get my proper arm reinstalled.
You changed your hair.
Same jacket.
No, new jacket. I saw him. Leia, I saw her son. He was here.
Where am I?
You're my guest.
Tell me about the droid.
He's a BB unit with a selenium drive and a thermal hyperscan vindicator.
It's carrying a section of a navigational chart. And we have the rest. Recovered from the archives of the Empire, but we need the last piece. And somehow you convinced the droid to show it to you. I know you've seen the map. It's in there. And now you'll give it to me. Don't be afraid. I feel it too.
I'm not giving you anything.
We'll see.
You're afraid that you will never be as strong as Darth Vader.
Don't let these dogs scare you. Trophy achievement is now ours. The Battle of Takodana level is complete, which means free play is unlocked. And we also got a gold brick for completing the level. And as I promised in the beginning, we fell half short of the halfway point to getting that true Jedi requirement. So we'll certainly need some assistance for some red bricks and a little more patience at a later date. So a couple of character tokens and vehicle tokens unlocked for us free. And we got a handful of unlocked ones that we can purchase too. So we'll go ahead and check those out at a later date when we get a little bit more studdage to spend. But we'll only need a few of those for the free play and free roam situations. We'll have all that information for you here soon enough. Speaking of which, that is going to wrap it up for LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens Level 6 Battle of Takodana. And that was the story version. We'll be back for the free play here soon. And we'll get all those collectibles, mini kits, red bricks, and all that stuff, as well as a whole bunch of studs. And hopefully you guys are enjoying this series so far. We're having a blast. I have to admit, this is probably my favorite LEGO game to date. They keep getting better and better with each release. Speaking of releases, if you guys have any questions or comments or requests about this release, head on over to Facebook, Twitter, or simply comment, vote, subscribe down below. Blah, blah, blah. That was easy for me to say, right? And of course, HappyThumbsGaming.com is available for your viewing pleasure. It's the home of our product and gaming reviews, as well as our trophy achievement guide. So make sure you check out those. Doug works real hard on those, putting those together for us. And we utilize those for our free play videos. So everyone always asks, how do you always know where all the mini kits are? Well, there's one word answer for it. Doug. So anyhow, off with the brown nose into Doug. We're off to go do some more videos. At least I am anyways. As always, until next time. You've got brown on you.